Hello everyone, we will configure EtherChannel in this lesson. Let me briefly tell you what EtherChannel does. Normally, we connect the switch to the firewall with a single cable and make a trunk on this port to ensure the communication of the VLANs between the two devices, but in case of a problem with this connection, the communication will be interrupted. To solve this problem, we can do both redundancy and load balancing by using multiple ports and configuring EtherChannel. In this example, we will configure layer 2 EtherChannel using port 5 and port 6. If you want to make layer 3 EtherChannel, I have written the commands you will enter here. Now let's go to the firewall side and start our configuration. Under the network tab, we come to interface. I do this lab work on the Fortigate 60E physical device. Here we call it create new interface. Here we select the interface type as the 802.3 name. We will use the link aggregation control protocol. Let our name be EtherChannel. I choose its role as LAN and remove automatic object creation. I do not give IP address because we will use layer 2. If you make layer 3 EtherChannel, you need to give an IP address. I say OK without choosing anything else. Now we have created our EtherChannel interface and we will create new VLANs under this interface so that our users can use these VLANs. I call it create new interface. Let it be called VLAN11. Here we select our EtherChannel interface and type 11 as the VLAN ID. Let our IP address be 172.161.1.254. I wrote our subnet mask. I turn off the automatic object. I turn on ping in DHCP server. I say OK. Let's create one for VLAN12. Let our name be VLAN12. Our type is VLAN. Let's choose our interface. VLAN ID 12. Our IP address is 172.161.2.254. I turn off the automatic object. I turn on ping. I misspelled this place. Let's correct it immediately. Let's also open the DHCP server and say OK. Let's refresh the page. We forgot to choose the ports we will use in EtherChannel interface. Let's immediately choose port 5 and port 6. I say OK. When we refresh our page, you can see that the interface is up. Under this interface, we will use VLAN11 and VLAN12. Now we have two connections between us and the switch, but our connection does not work until we make the settings on the switch side. So let's make our settings on the switch side. On the switch side, we will configure port 5 and port 6. Let's switch to configure mode. I write CONFT. I configure two interfaces at the same time using the interface range fast Ethernet 0/5-6 command. First, let's make our port a trunk. Now let's do the EtherChannel configuration. Our command is channel group 1 mode passive. You can set the mode as active or passive. Port aggregation protocol only works in Cisco, while link aggregation control protocol can be used on all brands. When you enter the channel group command, it automatically creates the EtherChannel interface. Now let's check our settings by typing end. I'm writing show EtherChannel summary. We haven't connected yet, so let's check again. S-layer 2 here stands for you, in use. Let's check again. Now that our connection is provided and the protocol is link aggregation control protocol, now let's go to our users and check if they are getting an IP or not. Let's open the command line and check if we can get an IP from the DHCP server. You can see here that he got his IP address. Now let's check our other user. You can see here that when we check the IP address, it takes the 12.1 address. Now let's also check the firewall side. When we come to the firewall side, let's refresh our page. Here you can see the number of IPs deployed from the DHCP server. I added a widget for DHCP to the dashboard and let's check it there. Here you can also see the details of the devices that received the IP. If our EtherChannel configuration was not successful, our users would not be able to access the firewall and obtain an IP address from the DHCP server. Because our configuration worked correctly, the users on VLAN11 and VLAN12 were able to communicate successfully. That's all we're going to tell you in this lesson, so goodbye to see you in our next lesson.